Hey guys, it's Jess. You're watching Keto Rewind. Welcome back to my channel. Before we get started, if you're new here, hit that subscribe button. You're not going to want to miss my weight loss journey using a ketogenic diet and intermittent fasting. And if you aren't new here, thanks for joining and coming on back. So let's get started. I am on, what is this, week 11 update. Now, last week, I did not have a loss on the scale. It was a holiday weekend and lots of other excuses. So I was curious what my numbers were going to be this week. And plus, I had to like re-lose all the bloat and the inflammation and all that from the previous week. So I was curious, you know. So I hop on the scale this morning and I am down 4 more pounds, making my current weight 265.0. I was so mad. I'm like, could you not give me a 0.2 more? So I could say 264, but it is what it is. I'm 265, which makes my total weight loss 44 pounds in 11 weeks. So on February 11th, 2019, I started out with my starting weight was 309 pounds, and today, 11 weeks later, 265. So that also means I have with my 140 pound weight loss goal, I have lost 44 pounds of it. So now I can say I only have 96 more pounds to go. It doesn't seem quite so big when you're just saying like two digits now. So I am officially so close. Like I'm getting there. I feel like I'm almost to that halfway point. It's so exciting. So, and plus I'm almost up to like one of those big ones, like 50, probably next week. I may be saying I'm down 50 pounds, you know, so tune back in. So anyways, week 11, I had a good week. I just did well. I felt like I was more like I was on point with everything. Like I was doing the 23-1 intermittent fasting window, which means I fast for 23 hours and I just have an hour window for eating. And in that hour window of eating, I consume my macros for the day. However, with that being said, I did learn a little bit more about OMAD, which is one meal a day, or 23-1. I found that I was stressing trying to get all those calories into one meal. And I found with lots of research, I really only need to hit my protein numbers for the day and obviously stay under my carb amount. So obviously under 20 net carbs, but I really didn't need to hit that fat window, which is good because I have not been hungry. And it's weird because I'm hardly eating anything these days. And how could I not be hungry? Like that's just, it doesn't make sense, but that's how it is on keto. You stay fuller longer. Intermittent fasting really does help with that. So what I want to clarify the fat. Now it is either if you're not doing any fasting at all, you're just eating keto, the fat number is really hard to hit, but it's also not really hard to hit considering what you're actually eating. Like I could eat 5 servings of nuts and you know, and only have like this little bit of nuts and be over my fat, numbers for the day. So it does matter like what types of fats and all that. So pay attention to them. But in general, that's really your limit. You don't want to hit beyond that because if you have excess fat like me, I'm morbidly obese and I've got so much, I've 96 pounds left I want to lose. You don't need excess fat. You don't need excess fat, period. So that's basically the number you shouldn't go over. Treat it just as like the carb number. You don't want to go over 20 carbs, you know. Well, you don't want to go over your fat number either. That'll slow your weight loss. So don't worry about hitting your fat number. If you're hungry and you need something and you have leftover macros, go ahead and eat. But if you're not hungry, you don't have to hit that fat number. Listen to your body. You know, there's no one way is the only answer type approach to keto. You basically follow your body's lead. So, and if you're losing and, you know, and it's working, don't mess with anything. You know, but if you're like me who was, my weight loss was maybe like 6 pounds a week and it slowed down to like 3 or 4. Or I guess if you count last week, it was 0. But that was because of I did overeat. We all talked about that. But anyway, you can watch that video here. But anyways, I have excess fat on my body. I don't need to hit those numbers. My body is, the whole point of this process is to take from my fat stored reserves on my body before taking fat from my food. So that's why I'm like, I'm totally not worried and I'm not stressing anymore and I'm not feeling so full. Because I'm not trying to hit that fat number. If I'm hungry, I'll have maybe a little bit more nuts, you know, and whatever, but I still won't go over that number. But in general, that number is a limit. That's not your goal. So it's your limit and below, not your goal to hit every day. So I hope that makes sense. I kind of had like a, oh, moment when I was researching and figuring this all out. So, but if you have questions, please comment below and I will be glad to help. I am only 11 weeks in my journey, but I feel like I live, breathe, eat everything keto for the past 11 weeks. I'm not sure how many days that actually translates to, but I feel like I am just more of an advanced or expert level on the keto process because I'm doing this. I was truly morbidly obese and I'm truly going through this process with the emotions, with the, you know, the tips, the struggles, everything. So please comment below. Let me help you. With all that being said, I have a non-scale victory to tell you about. So I went to Target and I went to Walmart last week, but I'm on the hunt for some workout pants because I need some that fit me. One of the parts of joining keto or doing keto, you lose so much weight, you got to buy a new wardrobe too. So it's pretty, if when people say, oh, keto is expensive, and you know, they're thinking that, oh, because you eat fruit and vegetables. No, it's because you lose so much weight, you gotta constantly buy new clothes. So anyways, I go to Target and I look through their workout pants. I tried a couple on. They just didn't hold me in the way I wanted them to. I didn't want to size down because then I don't want my butt hanging out or being super see-through. So I just wasn't happy with the selection. However, extra large did fit great. But I just wanted more compression or more control. So I didn't buy any. And I'm like, as I was walking out, I passed through like the shorts and it's hot. It's getting hot in Texas now. So, the 80s are back. But anyways, I go and I'm like, I wonder if I should try on some jean shorts. So I was like, what the heck? So I've been consistently in extra large for like the past 2-3 weeks now, with like random stuff I'm buying and wearing. And so I was like, let's try some non-stretchy jean shorts and let's see. So I grabbed 3 pairs, all size 16. I brought them into the dressing room and I'm sitting there like this, there's no way. There's no way these are gonna fit. No. Well, darn it, they did. They fit. Here's the picture of one of them. I mean, granted, my legs need a lot of work. I need to do some squats and then I get my legs ready, but I haven't worn shorts that short and I've just been so covered up for so long that it's weird to be able to like see leg again. But anyways, I was just so happy whether my legs look like crap in them or not. I was just so happy they fit. Size 16, this girl right here. And then bonus part, size 16 misses. Yeah, exactly. There is a difference between misses sizing and women's sizing. Women's sizing usually has a longer or a higher rise, more room for like a belly that they don't really do in the misses sizing. So it's just a different fit and different cut. I don't know why they do that. It seems silly to me. It makes it really confusing too, because like a size 14 woman's is actually smaller than a size 15. I don't know. It's just weird. So I might have just messed that up, but women's sizing typically runs bigger. Size 14 women's is usually like a 16 in misses. Or maybe it's the other way around. I forget. But either way, I didn't even look in the plus section, which is another weird thing because I normally just go to the plus. I don't even look at all that cute stuff in the misses sizing or section of the store. So I was just so happy. So I was this close to buying them, but I'm like, I just can't do it right now. I'm losing weight too quick. So, but it was just that the fact that they fit and I tried them on and I had the picture to prove it. They zipped up. I felt great. So it's a total 9-scale victory. If you're in a rut and you need to maybe get some more focus or motivation, go to one of the big box stores and try something on, you know, get your mind blown. So, and that gave me good energy for coming into this week because I'm like, yes, size 16, coming for you 14, next, you know? So anyways, that was my non-scale victory. And today I have to go to the cardiologist because if you haven't followed before, I have a heart condition, a genetic heart condition, and it's something I have to have checked all the time. I was born with this. There's no way out of it, but I am excited to go talk to her. And obviously she hasn't seen me in a while, so she's going to be proud of my weight loss. But I will tell you a follow-up of how that goes in my next video, but stay tuned for that. And by the way, my cardiologist is the one that recommended keto. So anyways, and my last thing I wanted to say, I feel like this whole process of me being morbidly obese was kind of a blessing in disguise. Granted, my health took a toll, no question about that. I feel like so many people are coming along this journey with me, and not only are they becoming ketoers themselves, but I also feel like they are changing their life. They're being inspired or motivated by me. And I feel like this whole process of me losing weight and being very public and open about it and raw and real, I think it's almost a blessing in disguise that I'm the one that's getting to go through this and showing, you know, my tips, my struggles, my experience, my, you know, whatever it is. I just feel like this has been a blessing in disguise because I'm helping so many people along the way. So if you're like me and you were looking for something like this, please subscribe to my channel. This is the type of stuff I talk about. I'm considering doing some more. I don't know if I'm going to do like a podcast or maybe some type of a video blog or something with more in detail emotional side of weight loss and all of that. You know, I'm considering a Patreon. I think that's the name of it. But anyways, I'll give you more details about that. But just some things that I can really give way more detail than I can in this like short little week keto transformation video. So, but anyways, I hope you have a great week. I'll catch you next week at week 12. I hope that I can say maybe I'm down 50 pounds next week, because I'm getting really close to that 50 pound number. So I will see you at the next video for my keto transformation. Bye, I'm Jess and you're watching Keto Rewind.